So we are in the midst of a coronavirus crisis. Is it just hype? Are we panicking unnecessarily? It's really difficult to work out what this is going to look like. People are saying that somewhere in mid-April, the UK is going to kind of catch up with Italy. How, as business people, as professionals, how can we get through this? What's going to be a few months of disruption, even if the estimates of what's going to happen are minimal, the precautionary measures the government are going to implement are going to be tricky for business people to navigate, whether that be people self-isolating, whether that be large gatherings being rescheduled, or even down to just simple things like people get nervous and decide not to commit and make decisions, purchasing decisions. So how, as business people, can we, and businesses, can we get through some of those challenges that are coming? So I was listening to Radio 4 this morning where George Osborne was talking about how he would respond, given we've got a budget this week on Wednesday, I think it is. And he was saying that, you know, a lot of the things that government did do to help businesses in scenarios like this take too long. So, you know, the usual things of funding and grants and support, they take too long to administer, they're too bureaucratic, and realistically, the next 2 or 3 months are going to be very challenging. Even if we don't get to some of the really scary stories that people are saying, it's going to be challenging because people will be nervous. Markets will be nervous. Customers will be jittery about committing expense. So what can we do as business people to minimize the risks to our businesses? So number one, obviously, there's the precautions around your own operations and health and the health of your employees and, you know, washing hands and all that kind of stuff. But what about the business and the revenue coming in? How can you protect against that? Well, if you've got insurance, that's great. But as a lot of people are finding out, the insurance isn't actually worth anything because business continuity, you as a business have to be affected rather than your customers affected. The government recently implemented a notifiable disease or incident, and people went to claim on their insurance and found that the insurance policy wording was such that it wasn't able to secure them a payout. So some people will struggle with the insurance side of this as well until it really ramps up, and by that time the damage has been done. So, yes, there are some businesses that are really going to suffer, and they just have to batten down the hatches with this. Tourists, holidays, flights, those kind of things, large public events. Some of the businesses that, you know, some of the football grounds that are playing matches with empty stadiums are going to really feel the pinch. But there are lots of knock-on businesses that come off that. The people who serve food and the restaurants and all of that kind of stuff that's going to happen. And there is no one-size-fits-all way to adapt to what is an uncertain period other than batten down the hatches. That's the simplest thing to do. For B2B businesses, which is who I work with a lot, there's a lot more you can do. You don't have to sell in person. You don't have to do a lot of things in person. The digital age has allowed that you can break up your workforce, put them in their homes, and get them on with their job. Sure, there will be adjustments and difficulties, but you can literally pick up the office, move to the home, and continue. Salespeople, you've got LinkedIn, you've got all of these different methods available, you've got the phone, you've got Skype, you've got all of this stuff that you can use to continue to promote and advance the business, not only to kind of minimize the shock that's coming, if there is a shock. I don't want to be kind of presumptive, it might all fizzle out, but it doesn't look that way. Not only do you want to minimize the shock of what might come from these measures that might come out today or in the next few days, but you actually want to be able to have some momentum behind you. So when this thing settles down, which they estimate is late late May, early June, we'll have seen the worst of it, that when this settles down, you can really hit the ground running. You're not going, oh, what are we doing now? Let's get going. You can actually go, let's just keep pushing forward. And some of this disruption will force some businesses to start taking digital and online more seriously. Businesses that perhaps have been reliant on interactions and one-to-one, suddenly, because of this virus, it will allow more businesses to see that we don't actually need to do this in person or that in person. We can actually adapt to interacting via email more or interacting via video conferencing much more than perhaps they have done already. But the key thing is do everything you can to minimize the disruption and pivot to digital as much as you possibly can. Later today, we'll know what our roadmap looks like over the next few weeks. But don't be caught by surprise by this. We as a business are making plans that this next 2-3 months could be very disruptive, and we're making alternative plans of how we get around that, how we can continue to do business without all of these personal interactions. How could we operate not only with a smaller team, but how could we operate in a more financially constrained period? Because the next 3 months, people are going to be holding on to their money a little bit more because they might be off sick. They might be not sure what's going to happen in their own supply chains. So it's how we adapt to a short, sharp shock that could ride out till early June. And if you're planning for that, and if you're working for that, you're going to be able to counter everything that's thrown at you and all the challenges that come much easier than somebody who just goes, oh, it'll all blow over. Let's better to plan for the worst and not see it happen than not plan and then get caught with your pants down. So yes, it does seem a bit scary what's going on, but there are loads of things you can be doing, particularly if you're B2B, to minimize the impact on your business, from, you know, encouraging hygiene and all that stuff to limit the infection in your business, remote working, all of that kind of stuff, but also pivoting to more digital channels to get your messages out there, to get in contact with customers, to keep relationships going. And you will find that will stand you in good stead as we come out of this in hopefully June time, that you will have sufficient momentum behind you that you will pick up through the summer months. And I'm sure the government's going to announce some measures to support business. There's talk of VAT relief. There's talk of PAYE relief and corporation tax relief that's going to be kicking in during this year as an exceptional item. George Osborne on Radio 4 was talking about minimizing or increasing the employer's NI allowance to ease the pressure on businesses over the next few months. So be ready, get ready, and do everything you can to thrive during the storm that might be coming our way.